Baking soda is a true miracle for people with kidney disease. A daily dose of baking soda can make your body more alkaline, can lower your serum potassium levels, and can even help patients stop the progression of chronic kidney disease and avoid the need for dialysis. So, today I'm going to show you everything you need to know about baking soda and kidney disease. I will show you dosages, uses, possible dangers, and also what to expect in terms of results from starting to take baking soda. Yes, today's video is going to be a handy guide to lower your creatinine levels using baking soda in just 10 minutes. My name is Katherine and I've been working with kidney disease patients for 7 years now. I've seen patients stopping the progression of kidney disease with an improved diet and lifestyle. And yes, when used wisely, baking soda is definitely the magic potion that can save your kidneys. But today, I'm also going to dispel some misconceptions. A lot of people here on YouTube are talking about baking soda without the proper knowledge. And this misinformation is really dangerous for people suffering from kidney disease. Remember that if you have any disease or you are taking medications, not all home remedies are safe for you. So don't start using baking soda without getting informed first, okay? Now guys, it's out of question that baking soda can save your life if you have kidney disease. So don't keep this golden nugget of information just for yourself. Share it with anyone you know who may benefit from a better kidney health. Click the share button below or send them an email. Now, baking soda is not going to give everyone the same results. The reason behind this, the most important thing you need to know about baking soda and kidney disease is this one, metabolic acidosis. Metabolic acidosis can be alleviated with baking soda. This is a complication of CKD, all right? Now, one of the most important jobs of the kidneys is to keep acidity, alkalinity in balance. In people with kidney disease, this balance is often compromised. The kidneys cannot remove enough toxins from the body and this causes acid to build up. This is not the same as heartburn, okay? Metabolic acidosis is a very dangerous condition because all this extra acid is going to cause damage to the whole body and mostly to the kidneys. This condition is characterized by symptoms such as fatigue, headache, fast heartbeat, nausea, and loss of appetite. Many kidney patients have these symptoms, okay? Now, untreated metabolic acidosis will also cause bone loss, endocrine disorders, and muscle loss. The other problem with metabolic acidosis is that it will cause further kidney damage. It will make kidney disease progress faster. So, in my opinion, being able to solve all these problems with a home remedy such as baking soda is absolutely amazing. This works because baking soda is alkaline and it neutralizes the effects of this excess of acid. But before starting to take baking soda, how to tell if you have metabolic acidosis? You need to do the CO2 blood test or serum bicarbonate level test. This test should be done regularly by kidney patients, but this is not always the case. So talk to your doctor and be sure that you're being tested for CO2. Now, the CO2 test is usually done as a part of the basic metabolic panel and of the routine health exams kidney disease patients should do regularly. So maybe you have already done it on your labs. It is called TCO2, okay? And the normal range for CO2 is 23 to 29 milliequivalent units per liter of blood. In case you are out of the range, meaning that your level is 22 or below, well, then you need to take baking soda. Okay, let's say that you actually need baking soda. How should you take baking soda and what are the correct dosages? Baking soda can be ingested or taken sublingually. Patients are recommended to start with small doses of sodium bicarbonate. Usually, the dosage is 1000 milligrams of sodium bicarbonate 3 times a day to start. Then, after a while, the patient needs to do the CO2 test again. The dosage will then be adjusted as necessary to maintain total CO2 level greater than 22 milliequivalents per liter of blood. Now, 1000 milligrams is about 1/4 of a teaspoon. Baking soda is usually taken several times a day to minimize the discomfort, so don't take it all together. Also, remember to take it between meals on an empty stomach to avoid bloating. Now, there are several ways a patient can take baking soda orally. You can find it in 840 mg capsules. Some patients prefer to take sodium bicarbonate in tablet format. Usually, one tablet is 650 mg. Both these products can be found in pharmacies or online. The advantage of taking it this way is that you don't have to bear the taste of baking soda. But if you don't mind the taste, it's also possible to use regular baking soda and buy it at the supermarket. This is what many people use to wash fruit and veggies or as a kitchen cleaner. It's just regular baking soda. You can put it in a glass of water and just drink it. Now, if you have to drink this, the taste is a bit harsh, but it costs a lot less and it's easier to find than the other formats. So, talk with your doctor, get tested for CO2. Then, if he advises so, start with a small dose of baking soda. Then, schedule another test as soon as you have to do your next analysis for CKD and see if things are going better or worse. Then your doctor can adjust your dose. Now, there are some questions about baking soda I receive in comment section multiple times, so I want to give you some definitive answers now to dispel some misconceptions. And by the way, guys, let me know if you are already taking baking soda and what is your experience with it. I know that many of you following me right now are very knowledgeable in this topic, so let everyone know about your experience. Now, what many patients ask is, why can't I just take baking soda without doing all these tests and analyses? There are mainly two reasons why this wouldn't be advisable. First of all, you don't know if it will help you, okay? If you don't have metabolic acidosis, if your CO2 levels are in the correct range, taking baking soda will just compromise this delicate balance. So, you could be doing more harm than good. Okay, this is not common, but can happen. It's important to know that baking soda as a supplement is safe. People take it to relieve heartburn. Sometimes I use it too. There are not many drugs it can have interactions with, and none of the most commonly prescribed drugs for kidney patients have interactions with it. Still, you should talk to your doctor before starting to take it. Also because of hypokalemia or too low potassium levels. Now, as I was saying, baking soda can be useful to lower serum potassium levels in kidney disease patients, which is good because kidney disease patients tend to have too high levels of potassium. So if you have high potassium levels, baking soda can help you. So this is another reason why baking soda can lower your creatinine levels. It reduces serum potassium levels. But there is a problem here. There is also the chance that your potassium is already too low. Yes, this is not impossible for kidney disease patients. It can happen, and if it happens, you don't want to make the situation worse by taking baking soda, alright? So, in conclusion, before taking baking soda, your doctor needs to monitor both your serum potassium and your bicarbonate levels. Now, another frequently asked question. Is it true that baking soda contains salt? Can it raise blood pressure? Yes, it's true that baking soda contains salt or sodium. Baking soda is also called sodium bicarbonate. So it is sodium. It's a different form of sodium actually. And yes, excess of sodium can raise your blood pressure. But with the right dosage for baking soda and a low sodium diet, this shouldn't be a problem at all. And on the other hand, if you already get too much sodium from the diet, adding baking soda can give you troubles, yes. So, my advice here is to start taking baking soda only with your doctor knowledge. This way, your diet can be adjusted for the slightly increased sodium intake. Another very frequent question, is baking soda the same as baking powder? No. They are not the same. Baking soda is sodium bicarbonate. It's what I'm talking about in this video. Baking powder is a leavening agent, something you put in baked goods like cakes and muffins. Not the same as baking soda, so don't use it instead of baking soda, okay? Now guys, if you have other questions, write them down in the comment section. I always do my best to answer all the questions I can. This is all for today. Thank you for watching.